midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. Okay, there's some Journey for you by request. And today, let's see here. Today we are going to look at point slope form. And it comes with an equation. And the equation is written down right here for you. It is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So you can write that, you can put that on your formula sheets actually. Okay, and that's what the main thing we'll be working with today. So let me quickly, this is a different form of linear equation. There's really three different forms. So put that one on there and then we'll move down here to notes. You can put this in your notes also if you want. There's three different forms of linear equations. And you guys have already gotten really familiar with y equals mx plus b, which is probably the one I would list first. There's also the one I just gave you, which is point slope form, y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And then the third one is ax plus by equals c. All right, so this is called slope-intercept is the first one. These are the names of them. Number two is point slope. And the third one is called standard. Standard form. Okay, so let me show you about point slope form. It's really nice for certain kinds of problems. And here's the first one, and this one's going to make it easier. It says a line passes through the point. Negative 3, 6, and has a slope of negative 5. Write the equation in point slope form. Okay, so I'm going to write down that equation. It's y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Okay, and the point is x1, y1. If I go over here and I pick the point out of the equation, I got those two things. The slope is 5. Write that down. So m equals 5. And the point is negative 3, 6. So this is going to be x1. This will be y1. I'm going to plug that in and I'll get my equation. So the y, it's y minus 6 equals, slope goes in front of the parentheses, 5 times x minus negative 3. All right, now the only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to clean up that double negative there. All right, the minus negative 3. And my answer is going to be y minus 6 equals 5 times x plus 3. And that's the answer. So you can see that was nice. I didn't have to find the y-intercept or anything like that. Okay. If you have any questions, write them down, bring them to class. I'm going to come back to this graph paper. I actually saved that for a different problem that I'll come back to. Just for ha-has for a minute, let's take that same equation here. If I went made a mistake. That was negative 5. I should correct that. That's negative. That's negative. Which didn't make much difference until I got to here. Supposing I gave you an equation like that, and I wanted you to go to slope-intercept form. You know, I'd have this equation, the same one I just did, y minus 6 equals negative 5 times x plus 3. And if I wanted to get into y equals mx plus b, what I can do is I can do the distributive property here. I get negative 5x, negative 15 equals y minus 6. Now, I just want to get y alone, so I'm going to add 6 to both sides, and I get y equals negative 5x minus 9. And that's what would it be in the other form. Okay, so that's how you go from one form to the other form. However, the question didn't ask for that. I just figured I'd show that out to you. Okay, all right. Number two. What is the equation in point slope form of the line with slope 2 and goes through negative 3. Okay, so I'm going to write down that equation. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Okay, so here's the important parts. The slope is 2. This one's the y x coordinate. That one's the y coordinate. So m equals 2. X1 equals negative 3. Y1 equals 5. I plug those values in here. I get y minus 5 equals m, which is the slope, times x minus negative 3. Okay, so once again, I got a double negative. I'm going to clean that up. That's the last thing I need to do. 2 times x plus 3. Okay, and that is it. That's the answer. Number three, suppose we go the other direction. List the point in the slope y plus 5 equals 1 half x minus 3. Okay, so slope, that's an easy one, right? That's right here in the formula, which is 1 half. And I'm looking also for the point. Now here's where it gets a little trickier. I need an x coordinate and I need a y coordinate. Okay, the x coordinate is next to the x. However, it's the opposite sign of what you think it'd be. Since it's minus 3, it's actually going to be positive 3 in the x. And this one, the plus 5, the y coordinate is next to the y. And since it's plus 5, it's actually going to be the opposite sign, but the same number. So instead of being positive 5, it'll be negative 5. So that would be the point that it goes through, and that would be the slope. Okay? And that's because we had the subtraction is built in. You know, up here we were looking at this and we had the double negative turned into plus 3. So when I see plus 3, I know the point's actually going to be a negative coordinate, right? Okay. Good on that? Great. That was number 3. I'm on to number 4. What is the equation of the line that goes through one, 4, and negative 2, negative 3? Okay, so this is the kind of problem where it's really easier to do the point slope form rather than y equals mx plus b, and I'll show you why. I still need the slope, which means I'm still using that formula that I gave you guys, the slope formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, I'm going to label my points here. I'm going to make the first point x1, y1. Second point's x2, y2. When I plug these values in, I get negative 3 minus 4 over negative 2 minus 1, which simplifies to negative 7. Over negative 3. I have negative and a negative in that fraction there, which means it's actually going to be positive 7 over 3. That's my slope. Now here's where it's really nice, because I can pick either one of these points here. I'm going to use that easy one. 1, 4, and I'm going to plug this into that point slope form, which means I go y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and I can go y minus y value is 4, m is 7 over 3, and x value is 1, and I'm done. I don't have to find the y-intercept, which is really nice, okay? So this is my x1, that's y1. Plug those values in, you get your answer. Okay, is that the only one? No, actually, I could have picked the other point if I had preferred with negative 2, negative 3. Y minus, let's see, the y is negative 3, so that becomes plus 3. M is still the same, that's 7/3. X is negative 2, which means when I plug it in, I get minus negative 2, which becomes actually plus 2. So this is also a correct answer. There's more than one correct answer there, okay? Either one of those would be great. In fact, there's actually an infinite number of correct answers because there's an infinite number of points in that line. Okay, so that's a nice problem for that. Why don't you try this one, and then I'll go to the graphing problem. I am on number 5. You try. What is the equation in point slope form of the line that goes through negative 3, 2, and has a slope of 1/4. Okay, so you should hit pause right now and go do it out. And if you do this out correctly, you get y minus 2. There's your 2. Slope is 1/4. There's the slope. And x minus negative 3, which comes from the negative 3 there. And then I can clean up my double negatives, make that a plus 3 instead of double negative. And that's the answer. Okay? All right. Here's my last problem. This is a graphing one, number six. I'm going back up to my graph paper for a second. So this is where, if I have a point here, and I got a point here, and then I got a point here. Oops. And the question goes like this: what is the equation of the line? So, because this one looks like it's got a yucky y-intercept. So I don't know, that's like maybe 2 1/3, 2 1/4. You could sit there and play with that for a long time, try to figure it out. That would be, not be the way I would do it. I am going over here. First of all, I'm going to find the slope, okay? So we have a graph, which means I can make a triangle. And I can look at the rise over the run. The rise is 2, the run is 3. That's going in the positive direction, which means my slope is 2/3 with rise over run. Okay. Now, the other thing I need is I need a point that that goes through. There's a 3 points there. You pick any one of them and use it. I'm thinking I'm going to use this point right here is -2, +1. So if I plug this into my formula, I'm going to get y -1, there's the 1, equals m, which is the slope of x minus, I need the x coordinate, which is -2. So if I clean that double negative up, I get y -1 = 2/3 x + 2. And you got to get rid of that double negative, okay? And that's the answer. And that is the last question I was going to run through with you guys. So if you got questions, please write them down, bring them to class. I look forward to seeing you all tomorrow. Thank you very much. Have a great night.